Hey guys, guess what? I just heard something groundbreaking happening in Dubai, and it's revolutionizing. Flying taxis. Yes, like in the fifth element. We've heard much about it, but only big words and no action. Now it's a big. UK architecture firm Foster Plus Partners, in collaboration with Skyports Infrastructure, has unveiled a concept that will change the game, a vertiport terminal designed for vertical takeoff and landing vehicles. Read air taxis. Imagine hopping into a cab that just lifts off into the sky. Phew, so much less traffic jam. This isn't just about futuristic travel, it's about connecting Dubai's most popular spots in a fast, efficient, and amazingly zero-emissions way. It's like stepping into a sci-fi movie, but it's real and happening here. The ruler of Dubai, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, has endorsed this project, highlighting its significance to the city. And here's the cool part, this vertiport would be right next to Dubai International Airport. Now that's convenient. It's designed to integrate seamlessly with existing airport networks and nearby transport hubs. This means you could land in Dubai, and in no time be whisking across the city in an air taxi from this ultra-modern vertiport. David Summerfield, the head of studio at Foster Plus Partners, said it will transform the way people travel in Dubai. I believe Dubai is just the beginning. So how exactly does it work? We're talking about a direct link with DXB and the Dubai Metro. Imagine landing in Dubai and seamlessly hopping onto an air taxi for a quick zip across the city. And get this, the design is straight out of a futuristic fantasy. Renderings show the terminal on an elevated deck, perfect for those air taxis to take off and land. The building itself wraps around the airfield, connecting arrival and departure lounges, and it offers stunning views of the aircraft and the city. It's not just a terminal, it's a viewing deck to the future. Now here's what is exciting. Air taxi stations are set to start operating in Dubai within the next 3 years. That's right, we're just a few years away from seeing this sci-fi dream become a reality. Dubai has been eyeing this flying taxi service for a while now. In 2017, the Dubai Road and Transport Authority discussed launching driverless passenger drones using a one-seat model by Han, a Chinese company. In 2022, the Chinese XPeng X2 actually did a public test flight right here in Dubai at the GITX Technology Expo. This two-seater flying car, fully electric and capable of hitting speeds up to 80 miles per hour, can lift off the ground vertically. Real-life flying cars, folks. DXB Airport is just one of four proposed locations for these vertiports: Dubai International Airport, Palm Jumeirah, Dubai Downtown, and Dubai Marina. These sites will not just be landing pads, they will be connectors between Dubai's most popular areas, offering fast, efficient, and emission-free travel. Skyports Infrastructure and RTA plan to roll out these networks for air taxis by 2026. Imagine we could be hailing air taxis like cabs in just a few short years today. The CEO of Skyports, the company behind those amazing vertiports, promises that Dubai will be the first city in the world to integrate a fully developed network of flying taxi into its public transportation system. But this race to the skies isn't just happening in Dubai. Cities like New York, Los Angeles, and Paris are also eyeing these short-term personal helicopter rides. Major airlines like Delta, American, and United are getting into the mix, looking at futuristic ways to transport passengers to and from airports. And here's another cool bit, Joby Aviation, a US startup specializing in electric takeoff and landing vehicles, or EVTOLs, is joining forces with Skyports. These EVTOLs are the heart of this initiative. They're compact, electric, and designed to be much quieter than regular helicopters. Zipping through the city sky without noise and pollution is the future we're looking at. Besides the taxis, there are still a lot of questions in the air as well. Do these taxis compare more to cars or to aircraft? Is the person operating it a driver or a pilot? Does the driver have to have a pilot license? Or do we need a completely new vehicle operating license for these? Or could these flying taxis be completely autonomous and driverless? Is air traffic control involved in managing these? And would you be comfortable taking a ride on these futuristic taxis? Let us know in the comments and follow Live and Let Fly for more updates about this project.